In this video, we are going to discuss about velocity tangles diagram for Francis turbine, where we will formulate work done, hydraulic efficiency, mechanical efficiency, and overall efficiency of turbine. And also we will see working proportions of Francis turbine. The Francis turbine is an inward flow reaction turbine in which water enters the turbine in radial direction at outer periphery of runner and leaves in axial direction. Here figure shows general layout of hydroelectric power plant using reaction turbine, where gross head represented as HG is the difference of level between head race and tail race. HF is the frictional loss in penstock and capital H is net available head at turbine, that is HG minus HF. To draw velocity diagram of an inward radial flow reaction turbine, that is Francis turbine, I will consider only one blade which is moving with velocity u. Now the water jet with velocity v1 is strike tangentially to one end of blade at inlet, and the angle of water at inlet is alpha to the runner. This means water coming from guide vanes to the runner at the certain angle, and this angle is known as alpha. Now this inclined line of absolute velocity of water at inlet, that is v1, is resolved in two components. One component is horizontal component and other is vertical component. So first we draw one horizontal line, and this line is known as velocity of reel at inlet, that is vw1, and other is vertical component, that is velocity of flow at inlet, that is vf1. Now in this diagram we add another two velocities. So on the line of vw1 up to certain point we are indicating velocity of blade at inlet, and I will connect these two points and it will represent the relative velocity of jet at inlet, and the angle of relative velocity with horizontal direction is indicated as theta, and it is known as blade angle at inlet. So here we have completed inlet velocity tangle for Francis turbine. Now we'll draw outlet velocity tangle for Francis turbine. So in Francis turbine, discharge is radial at outlet, that is angle beta is 90 degrees, and when the beta is 90 degrees, the velocity of water at outlet, that is V2, is in the vertical line, because suppose this inclined line V1 completely vertical at outlet, then horizontal part VW2 will be 0. That means V1 and VF1 lines are same at outlet. Therefore V2 equal to VF2 and W2 is 0. Now next we indicate the relative velocity line at outlet. So this inclined line is relative velocity line VR2. It makes the angle phi with the horizontal direction. So this horizontal line here is known as velocity of blade at outlet, that is U2. So here we completed velocity tangles diagram for Francis turbine. Next we will move to the work done equation for Francis turbine. In case of Francis turbine, work done per second, which can be written from Euler's momentum equation, where Q is discharge through nozzle in meter cube per second, which is area multiplied by velocity. Here positive sign is taken when beta is less than 90 degree and negative sign is taken when beta is more than 90 degree. Here maximum work occurs when beta is equal to 90 degree, where V2 is minimum and VW2 is 0. Therefore, equation for work done per second is reduced to this one. And work done per second per unit weight of water is given by this formula. Now here D1 and D2 are the outer and inner diameters of runner rotating at n rpm. So tangential velocity at inlet is denoted as U1 and is given by formula pi D1 n by 60. And tangential velocity at outlet denoted as U2, which is given by formula pi D2 n by 60. Now hydraulic efficiency of turbine is given by formula, that is power developed by runner capital P divided by input power or water power, where capital H is net head available on turbine. So here rho Q get cancelled and we'll get the formula for hydraulic efficiency of turbine. And mechanical efficiency of turbine is given by shaft power divided by power developed by runner. And overall efficiency of turbine is given by shaft power divided by input power, that is rho GQH, and it will also equal to hydraulic efficiency multiplied by mechanical efficiency. Hydraulic efficiency of inward radial flow reaction turbine ranges from 80 to 90%. Now we will see the working proportions of Francis turbine. In that, first one is ratio of width to diameter, represented by small n, and this value ranges from 0.1 to 0.45. The speed ratio is the ratio of tangential velocity at inlet to the theoretical jet velocity, called as spotting velocity, that is under root of 2gh, and the value of speed ratio ranges from 0.6 to 0.9. Next is flow ratio. It is the ratio of velocity of flow at inlet to the theoretical jet velocity, called as spotting velocity, and the value of flow ratio ranges from 0.15 to 0.30. The discharge rate through Francis turbine neglecting thickness of blade is given by this formula, where suffix 1 represents the condition at inlet of runner blades and suffix 2 represents the conditions at outlet of runner blades. And if blade thickness is considered, the discharge formula will be this one, where small n1 will be the number of runner blades and small t is the thickness of blades. Now here, instead of pi d1 minus n1t, we write down kt pi d1, and here kt is known as vane coefficient, and it is generally taken as 0.65. Next is velocity of reel, vw1, can be calculated from the equation of hydraulic efficiency. Next is to calculate guide blade angle alpha and the blade angle theta from inlet velocity triangle. So we are applying the equation of tan alpha, that is opposite side by adjacent side. The opposite side is vf1 and adjacent side is vw1. Or to find tan theta, the opposite side is vf1 and adjacent side is vw1 minus v1. And to calculate blade angle at exit, that is phi, we are applying the equation of tan phi, which is opposite side by adjacent side, where opposite side is vf2 upon adjacent side u2. So by using all these equations, you are able to solve the problems on Francis turbine.